lecture. Today we are going to learn the last part of acid, bases and salt chapter. In our previous video we have already learnt about what is neutralization, and after neutralization we learnt about how acids are reacting with metals, how bases reacts with the non-metals, and many of the chemical equations we saw in our last video. In today's video we are going to learn about how does a salts are formed and what are the different types of salts. Like we learnt in neutralization how salts are formed. Now further we are going to study about what are the different types of salts. Further, what is the reaction of the salts with the acids and bases. Further, we are going to study about electrolysis. What is the process of electrolysis? So let us start now with our video. Our first topic today is where we are going to study about is reaction of acids with the carbonates and bicarbonates of metal. Okay, so in our next chapter we are going to study how is carbonates and bicarbonates are formed. Okay, and in this one small reaction is there, which the reaction is again repeated over there in that chapter also. So here we are going to study the reaction of acids. First we are going to speak about acids and their reaction with the carbonate and bicarbonate metal. So there is only one reaction given here, is when CaOH2 aqua plus CO2, which is carbon dioxide, gives to us what? CaCO3 plus H2O. What a molecule is giving out, okay, is in a liquid form. So we get a byproduct as a water molecule here. Okay, and CaCO3, which is calcium carbonate. Okay, this is calcium carbonate we are getting. Now how we are getting this calcium carbonate? See here, dear students, this calcium goes and get attached with this carbon dioxide, but one oxygen we need here. So here, from here we are taking one oxygen over here, because there are two oxygen over here. So two molecules and one oxygen goes here. So here remaining is H, and one oxygen comes out from here. So it becomes H2O. Again, I am explaining here. Dear students, please pay attention. How does this reaction get balanced? When calcium goes and get attached with this. Now this OH2 is, this two is common for oxygen is two molecule and hydrogen also two molecule. Out of this two molecule, if one molecule I am giving it to this CO2, so this CO2 becomes what? CO3. When we are getting here CaCO3, which is calcium carbonate, we got it here. After getting calcium carbonate, what happens here is, what is remaining? H2 and one molecule of oxygen is remaining. Well, we get this as H2O. So in this way, this particular equation get balanced, where we are doing a reaction of an acid with the carbonates and bicarbonates of a metals. So this part is there on page number 68. Let's read it out and we will come to know more properly. There's one activity which is given. The activity is cancelled there. Okay, but before, we will just go through the reaction part. Okay. In an activity, what happens? The activity when a lime water comes in contact with a gas released in the form of an efficiency, it turns it into milky. Okay, when the lime water comes in contact with this, it turns into milky white solution. This chemical reaction tests for carbon dioxide gas. When a lime water turns milky, we infer that the efficiency is of a carbon dioxide gas. This gas is produced on a reaction of an acid with a carbonates and a bicarbonate salts of a metals. A precipitate. Now what do I mean by a word precipitation? Precipitate means that white milky solution here is called a precipitate. Okay. What you can do is, you can just take this chalk. Okay, our chalk. Rub it nicely, make a powder, add little water in it. What happens? That white precipitate is a white solution is formed here. Of a calcium CaCO3 is formed, produced in a reaction with a lime water by CaOH2. This reaction can be represented by a chemical equation. So this chemical equation I have written here which is when CaOH2 plus CO2 will give us what? CaCO3 plus H2O. Further, now today we are going to learn about salts and types of salts. What is salts and what are the different types of salts? Dear students, the theory which is given on page number 68, I have formed into point wise, and I have noted down on the board. Just to explain here, you can mark this all the points in your textbook itself, because the type of salt is acidic salt, where pH value is always less than 7. The basic salts, where the pH value is always greater than 7. And neutral salts, where the pH value is always equal to 7. So let us see now their definition one by one. Okay, this definition is already there in your textbook. You can mark down this definition in the textbook. It is on page number 68. So remove page number 68 and you will get this all definitions. I've written in point wise so that it is easy for you all to remember. So our first definition is acidic salts. An acidic salt is formed by neutralization reaction between a strong acid and a weak base. The two important words in this definition is what? Strong acid and weak base. The pH of the aqueous solution of an acidic salt is less than 7. As we have already learned in our pH strip, when it is less than 7, it is called as an acid. When it is more than 7, it is called as a base. And when it is only 7, neutral, it is called as neutral. And we have seen many examples where there's one chart also in your textbook which represents that which ingredients comes with more than 7, which comes less than 7, which is neutral, like water. Okay, all these things we have already gone through. So yeah, how you are going to remember this definition? You will remember two words over here. In an acidic salt formed by neutralization reaction between a strong acid and a weak base, where the value of pH is always less than 7. Let us say its example. What is it? It's example NH4Cl. Next definition is basic salts. A basic salt is formed by a neutralization reaction between a weak acid and a strong base. So here, what you will remember? Weak acids and a strong base. Example is CH3COONA. Okay, so here this is an example. Okay, what is the definition for neutral salts? A neutral salt is formed by neutralization of a strong acid and a strong base. Both are strong over here. Here we saw it is weak acids and a strong base. Here we have seen strong acids and weak base. But in neutralization, it is what? Strong acid as well as strong base. The aqueous solution of a neutral salt has a pH equal to 7. And the example here we have given NaCl, KCl are the examples of a neutral salts. So dear students, in this way, there are three important types of salts. One is acidic salt, one is basic salts, and one is neutral salts. We saw the definition of acidic, basic, and neutral. Please do mark down these all definitions in your textbook. Now further we are going to do is, you can do this activity also. Classify the following salts into three types: acidic, basic, and neutral. Sodium sulfate, potassium chloride, ammonium nitrate, sodium carbonate, sodium acetate, sodium chloride. Now mark this as an activity for you all, which you can submit the answer till Monday on virtual ED only. No, not to give this answer in comment section. So dear students, mark this question as a small assignment for y'all. You can complete this in Saturday, Sunday time, and till Sunday, please put it down on virtual ED only. No comment section. Okay, not to use comment section for the answers. So what is the question over here? What you have to do is take a paper, make three columns: acidic salts, basic salts, and neutral salt, and classify all these elements and put it down on virtual ED. Now we are going to do our next question is complete the reaction in the following table. So all these reactions we will learn, and we will complete all this reaction and understand this reaction more better. So let us now start completing our. Complete the following table. So now, dear students, let us move towards the complete reaction of the following table. Okay, now one by one we will see all the reactions of the salts. In our previous video, we saw the reactions with the metals. Today, we are going to see metals, how acids are reacting with the metals. Today, we are going to see how carbonates of the salts are reacting with the acids and other elements. Okay, dear students? So, first we will see about how is a carbonate salt and diluted acids get reacted, where we get a salt of a metal with the carbon dioxide. Okay, dear students? So, first reaction is we are going to take is sodium carbonate. What we are going to take is sodium carbonate. So, when we are taking Na2CO3 plus, which acid we are going to react it with is HCl. We will get here, see here, this goes and attach over here. So, this becomes 2NaCl plus carbon dioxide plus water. Everywhere in a byproduct, you will get carbon dioxide and water. Carbon dioxide and water. So, this much you have to always remember. And one more thing you have to remember is the carbonate, okay, goes and attached to any of the other elements, okay. So, here when sodium carbonate gets reacted with HCl, it will become sodium chloride. Sodium chloride. But it is students, since this sodium goes and attached with chlorine molecule. Again, when sodium carbonate gets reacted with H2SO4 is which acid? Sulfuric acid. When it reacts with sulfuric acid, it will become what? Sodium sulfate. Okay, so it becomes Na2SO4. Na2SO4, again we are getting here what? CO2 and H2O. Now what happens? One carbon atom comes from here and go and attach with this. So this becomes H2O, becomes water molecule, and this becomes carbon dioxide CO2. Remember in this way, don't by heart it, understand it and practice it. You will understand it more better and you will remember more better rather than by hearting it. Again, the next is we are taking calcium carbonate. When calcium carbonate get react with HNO3, it will go and attach with NO3. So we are getting CaNO3 2 plus carbon dioxide plus water. Again, potassium carbonate K2CO3. Again, this K2 goes and attach with SO4. So that's why it will become potassium sulfate K2SO4 plus carbon dioxide plus water. Again, the whole part I am explaining here, and this table you have to complete where? In your textbook. There is no need of writing into your notebooks. But one thing is that if you want to practice, please practice and then you can write it down at the end of the completing your notes. All these reactions, total reactions of this chapter, you can write it out once only in your notebook after completing the chapter. But before that, start completing into your textbook and please do write in your textbook. These reactions are very, very important. Again, I'm explaining here. See, what happens when sodium carbonate get react with an acid, HCl will give us what? Sodium chloride CO2 plus H2O. Same way, sodium carbonate getting react with another acid, which is what? Sulfuric acid, H2SO4, will give us what? Sodium sulfate, carbon dioxide plus H2O. Calcium carbonate getting reacted with nitric acid, HNO3. Therefore, we are getting here CaNO3 plus CO2 plus H2O. Next, potassium carbonate again reacting with H2SO4, which is sulfuric acid. We will get potassium sulfate plus CO2 plus H2O. Now further, we will move and we will see how bicarbonate salts and dilute acids and other reactions. Okay. Now here we took is the carbonate of the salts. Here we are taking up bicarbonates of the salt. So first bicarbonate of the salt is sodium hydrogen oxide. How we are going to read here? Sodium hydrogen carbonates. Okay. Sodium hydrogen carbonates when react with HCl, we will get what? NaCl here itself plus what we are getting? Carbon dioxide plus H2O. Again, same reaction. Again, we are taking potassium hydrogen carbonate, okay, plus HNO3. Again, this K and O attached with this, so we get KNO3 plus CO2 plus H2O. again we are taking a sodium hydrogen carbonate plus, what is this acid called as, anyone? Please message me, what is this acid called as? Okay, CH3COOH. You can write this answer in your comment section also. What is the name of this acid? It is also called as vinegar, but what is the actual name of this acid? You can comment in the comment section. Let me see how many comment comes on this video. What is the name, another name of this acid, CH3COOH? Where I am going to get here is CH3COONa plus CO2 plus H2O. Now, what is the name of this acid, CH3COOH, which is called as sodium acetate? What it is called as? Sodium acetate. You have to mention the name CH3COOH. Okay, dear students, so in this way, we completed our whole part on salts. Okay? Further, we are going to learn about this water crystallization. Now, among these topics, there are certain topics which are cancelled. Now, all these activities which are there, they are cancelled for this academic year. Dear students, all the activities which are there, they are only cancelled for this academic year according to 25% syllabus is less. So, mark down what is cancelled. This activity on page number 69, which is this activity is cancelled. Then further, all this activity part is cancelled. Okay, but and use your brain power, another dilution of but I am going to teach you all what is electrolysis. Okay, what is electrolysis, and then we will try to complete our chapter today itself in this video. Electrolysis and electrolysis of water, two topics I am teaching. Rest, all the activity part, do not learn anything from there, because those parts are being cancelled. Because all these activity parts are not there for your this academic year according to the 25% reduced syllabus. So let us now move towards our next topic, which is called as an electrolysis of water. Okay, so which is electrolysis and electrolysis of water, which is on page number 71. So dear students, remove page number 71 and we will start going through this particular topic. So now let us go through this particular topic, electrolysis. Open your textbook, which is on page number 71, electrolysis. Now already we have done some small examples and small experiments when we were in lower classes. We took a solution of what we can say salt and water. Under that, electrodes were dipped and then the current starts passing. In this way, we have seen many of the electrodes, rods are there. There are two sites there, cathodes and anode sites, where the reaction starts, where positive ions and negative ions are generated. So this in short, they have explained us what is electrolysis over here. So just we will go through the topic, just read it out. There is no, like this topics are like electrolysis only definition part may can be asked for the exam, but in detail this part is reduced from the syllabus. Procedure: take a solution of 1 gram of copper sulfate and 50 ml of water and 100 ml capacity beaker. Use a thick plate of a copper anode and carbon rod at cathode. So here two plates they are taking, anode they are taking, a copper and carbon rod at cathode. Arrange the apparatus as shown in the figure as pass on an electric current through the circuit from some time. Do you see any changes? So what we are going to connect it to the battery and we are going to pass an electric current. Now when does the electric current start flowing? When there are two charges which are present. Which charges are those? Positive charge as well as a negative charge. Now we are going to see further what is the reaction, what does it happen. In the overactivity, copper appears to be having a deposit on the position of the cathode immersed into a solution. However, how did this happen? When electric current starts flowing through a circuit, the cations, that is Cu++ ions in a solution, get attached towards cathode. Okay, they get attracted or they get attached towards what? Cathode. Positive charge? start moving over there. Okay? And deposit of the copper appears to be at cathode. Even through the Cu plus ions, the solution was used in this manner. The color of the solution remains the same. Besides, while using an electric current pass on, the electron were moved from a copper atoms to an anode and then sent to the battery through an electric wire. The copper Cu++ ions formed in this manner enter the solution. In this way, decomposition of the solute in the solution takes place due to electric current. Decomposition of the solution. Means what? It starts mixing with the solution. Okay? There are the cathode reaction and an anode reaction. The two parts of electrolysis process that takes place in the overactivity is shown below. So there are two reactions. One is at cathode, one is at anode. See the reaction in your textbook at cathode where Cu2 plus aqua and two electrons are added. So what happens? It becomes Cu solid. As well as at anode, when two electrons are given out, what happens? Cu solid will give us what? Cu2 plus aqua and two electrons negative are accepted here. Okay? And then the two electrons are donated. So that way the reaction keeps on moving here. Further, always remember part is cancelled. Use your brain power is cancelled. Okay? Then electrolysis of water. Just you can just go through this reaction, like activity again is cancelled. You just go read it. So if you want an extra knowledge to go through it, okay? So it is found in the overactivity that the volume of the gas is formed by cathode. Again, here we are going to speak about cathode and anode. So basically here we are going to speak about how does a charge is formed at a positive level as well as a negative level. So in this way, dear students, we have completed all the important topics of acid, bases and salt. All the IMP topics in detail I have taught you all in all these following videos. Okay, and from next video I am going to start with the numericals. There are some small I think 4 or 5 numericals based on molarity, okay, which is there in this chapter. After that, on Monday's video I am going to give you all more 2 practicals and I will complete